Given the overall pattern of human genetic diversity, what does this tell us about biological concepts of race? Now, race is an ambiguous, often culturally burdensome term. If we are to talk about the concept of race, we need to be clear exactly what we mean by that. One fair genetic definition of race would be a group of individuals who are more closely related to one another than they are to individuals outside that group. I think most people would agree that if the term race is to be useful in describing general human genetic variation, then it should meet that criterion. Now we can ask a separate question, whether race categories common in the US meet the criteria of genetic races. For example, the Venn diagram here serves to help illustrate the concept. This Venn diagram is consistent with what is expected of alleles if our genetic definition of race is meaningful. It shows the degree of overlapping alleles between races and the degree of unique alleles within races. Now, if these geographic categories reflect genetic races, then we expect there to be some overlap of genetic variation between these groups, but importantly, we also expect to see a substantial amount of non-overlapping genetic variation, reflecting that unique diversity that allows them to qualify as a genetic race. From the information provided earlier, is the actual pattern of genetic variation within these groups consistent with the Venn diagram shown here? Well, the answer is clearly no. The actual pattern of human genetic variation looks more like what we see here, with a little bit of genetic variation that is unique outside of Africa. Even within Africa, remember that two people randomly drawn from Africa are as genetically different from one another as one person drawn from Africa and one person drawn from anywhere else in the world. As such, the African continent does not reflect a group of individuals more genetically similar to one another than to individuals outside of Africa. Africa does not fit our genetic race definition. Similar statements are true anywhere in the world when we're looking at parent population to founding population. When we look at areas, geographic areas that reflect the parental variation versus geographic areas that reflect the daughter variation.